Hey, it's Alex.
What's going on? It's Eric.
We're about to be on Truth or Dab.
I'm nervous AF.
The episode is going up. Watch it now.
Can't wait.
Check us out.
Check it out.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? From First We Feast, I'm Sean Evans, and welcome back to another exciting episode of Truth or Dab, the Hot One special, where we give our guests two simple options: tell the truth or suffer the wrath of the last dab. And today I'm very excited to welcome Alex Guarnaschelli and Eric Adjepong. She's the Food Network mainstay you know from iconic shows like Chopped and Iron Chef America, as well as her Midtown Manhattan restaurant, Butter. He's the Top Chef finalist and co-founder of Pinch and Plate, and together they tag team the cooking competition series Alex vs. America, which returns for season 2 on Food Network very soon. Alex and Eric, welcome to the show.
Oh my goodness, Sean, thank you for having us.
We're so excited. We're like super fans that we can't believe we're here.
Yeah. Well, I hope that we're friends still at the end of all of this. And let me explain what's going on here. So you guys have a plate in front of you, some wings. They've all been doused in various versions of the last dab. I have a set of deeply personal, potentially awkward questions for each of you.
Okay.
And when I ask you a question, you have a choice. Answer it honestly or escape the truth by eating a death wing. And Alex, we're gonna start with you.
What if you lie? Can I just lie?
I guess we'll never know.
That's true.
You know? Thinking back on all the cooking competition shows that you've done, whether it's recurring judge or a guest cameo, who is the most savage or intense food critic you've ever come across?
I don't know if you can say that out loud.
Who's the most savage?
Ruthless.
I mean, it has to be Scott Conant. It really does. I mean, that guy is just like, he laughs. He's like, oh, this is terrible. And you just watch, you know, young chefs' careers crumbling like buildings. So I'm going to say Scott Conant,
and he's no longer my friend. And he does it in a great briefy suit, too. Yeah.
No longer my friend, and it was worth it.
All right, Eric, we're going to switch over to you.
All right.
And a chance to throw some bombs yourself.
Jeez.
You were a finalist on Top Chef Season 16, competed in Season 17 All-Stars. Be real. Of all the judges that you came across, which one had the worst palate?
The worst? Oh my God.
How's that wing looking?
Oh man.
Do you have any blue cheese dressing?
Jeez. I'm gonna have to say, not the worst, but the hardest to figure out.
Grand no, Evan. He said the worst.
Oh my goodness. All right, I'm trying to switch it up. You know what? I would say the worst palate then would probably be, sorry, Graham. Graham Elliott. Yeah, probably.
You did not. We are friends are dropping it's, like
yeah,
flies.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It was tough to just find his like sweet spot, right? And figure out what exactly it was that he appreciated in food. So I had a really like uphill battle trying to figure out for other people, like with Padma, it's ethereal. With Tom, it's like craftsmanship. With Graham, I was just like, I don't get it. I don't know.
Sorry, wild card.
Yeah,
he's
yeah.
a wild card. Hard to figure out. Shout out to Graham. Shout out
Love
to
you,
Chicago.
Chef. Yes, legit.
Moving on to the next round and so far unscathed.
Okay.
And in round 2, I have a question for both of you. So feel free to talk amongst yourselves, but I'll need separate and individual answers in order to avoid eating a wing.
You're not making this easy whatsoever. All right, let's do it.
You've both worked in Michelin-starred restaurants, run acclaimed kitchens of your own. I'm curious, what is a fine dining upcharge or trick that you think most disproportionately benefits the restaurant over the diner?
Oh, that's easy. Breakfast. You could charge like $30 for breakfast and an omelet costs, what, $2?
Yeah, but it costs $800 to pay the guy to make
it. You're right, you're absolutely right. What do you feel like?
I feel like it's time to eat a wing.
Yeah, I say let's go for it.
Bon appetit.
All bon right. appetit.
Let's do it.
It is happening.
What are you going for?
It's going down.
Number one, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
We're diving into the Apollo. Always curious.
Mmm.
That's not bad.
A little spicy.
It's spicy.
That is spicy. Mmm. I feel all my inhibitions going into this wing.
This is a slow creeper.
That's what happens with this one. Yeah.
Oh
you know.
My God.
Mmm. It's cooking now.
Mom, is that you? Remember in Zoolander when he had to get his hair cut when they did the walk-off? Whew.
That's intense. Okay. It's still going.
Wow, I'm gonna start drunk dialing my fourth grade boyfriend. It's time for some milk.
And you know what? Things are only getting spicier here as we move on to the third round. Alex?
Yes?
We're gonna stick with you. All right? It's impossible to deny the influence of Food Network personalities, but in your opinion,
yes,
which Food Network superstar has the worst restaurant or restaurants in real life?
Oh my God. Are you serious?
I don't understand. Do you not want me to talk? Did you just call me here to eat?
I have a front row seat.
You gotta take the second one.
Right? I can't.
Yeah, you gotta go straight
up. I can't answer that, right? Eric, little private meeting. Can I have it? Can I talk to him about it?
Can we?
Phone a friend? All right. Yep.
What do you think? Lifeline. Should we do it or not? Now it's we.
Let's give the people what they want.
I can't answer that. Mm.
You can't answer that.
I can't.
I'm doing
total
it for you.
Class move from
many,
Alex.
Many thoughts. Many, many coursing through my veins. And, you know.
So, Sean, is this supposed to be hotter than the last?
So here on this show, you know, on Hot Ones, when you do the 10-wing gauntlet, you can kind of creep your way up. You know, it's almost like you're sitting in a hot tub and it's going up 1 degree at a time. This show, though, such a steep ramp up because we just start at 10. So it's like no matter where you go here, it's just total Sophie's choice. Like no matter what you eat, it's just going to be.
This is like a jacuzzi in hell. It really is.
Oh my God. Sweats.
Alex sweats. Going in.
Wow.
That's a decent bite.
Well, I mean, we are chefs. I don't want to get
that. That's a really strong bite. All right.
And Eric, I noticed that you took a bite there. It's like you ate for Alex's question.
I actually
have a question for you.
I'm ready for it. Let's do it.
I know that you're working on a pair of cookbooks right now.
Indeed.
To avoid eating a wing here, I want you to pick out a title, okay? Uh-huh. A widely available cookbook that you think is the most overhyped or overrated based on the quality of recipes in it.
Huh. Were you up all night?
Seriously.
What are you piercing through? Are you a shrink? Are you a channeler from
that's
hell?
It's a therapeutic experience that we're
so
going through here.
So a cookbook that's overly hyped in title.
Is the hot sauce kind of clouding your brain?
Right now I'm going fast. Yeah, I don't know if I'm doing. Oh, jeez.
Really, you can't? You can't think of one?
Oh, look, I saw that devious. That was a devious
smile. Can I phone you? All right, Toby.
What do you think?
An eyebrow pop from Alex.
I mean, I can't. You can't say what I think.
I don't want to say it. No, I have something in mind.
Yeah, I know. We wouldn't.
I got to work with this guy. All right. Here we go.
Chefs are pirates. Like, you can't give away the secrets of the Black Pearl.
I know, but that's the magic of this show. The magic of this show.
That is intense. Not as hot as the first one.
Just wait.
curious your thoughts, Eric, from a culinary perspective, like on these kinds of sauces.
I'm sweating now, number one. These are, like, I like spice, I like heat. This is just like five alarm though. This is insane. Like,
I think I'm drooling.
Yeah, like all your like, I'm sweating now, salivating as well. Like, but the wings are good. Like these are some solid wings other than that. Like the wings are delicious. This is tough.
The food is so far surpassing the hospitality of your questions.
I know, and I feel so bad because we started off on such a good foot, you know, and then this is what happens. It's a Burning Bridges show, and I'm a Burning Bridges host, you know, just by inviting people out here.
we're gonna have you for dinner after this.
I owe the payback.
What are we feeding Sean? That's a good question, yeah.
It's gonna be a tasting menu.
All right, moving on, and we have you guys eating wings. Let's try to draw it back a little bit. You're both cooking competition pioneers, but we know not everything is as it seems on TV. Can you give us a trade secret, a pull behind the curtain, something that would shock your average viewer?
Commercial breaks, stuff that happens like in between shots, right? It's a true production. I think a lot of people don't realize like there's a culinary team, there's an art department team, there's a audio and visual, right? So there's a true like production going on, and I feel like a lot of people don't get that because they're watching the commercials and the ins and outs, like the food that the judges are eating and what's happening. This is a show in the show, I feel like, during the commercial break. What about you?
My whole childhood is flashing before my eyes because my whole mouth is burning. My first instinct is to say, I've never eaten a plate of truly hot food.
Oh, right. You know, that's interesting. We can trade notes on this because I always think logistically it's complicated to do food within a show. You know, it's hard like to base on like when the time is going to be to eat it. You know, there's so many spinning plates that it is hard to snap that Rubik's Cube into place.
And when people make ice cream, if it's desserts, if someone makes ice cream and someone else doesn't, I've seen chefs fight over the fact that the ice cream was held in the freezer during the judging. That kind of small nuance
right.
can set a set ablaze. Let me put it to you. I mean, it seems apropos. Or
no
I should
one knows
speak.
Better
There's
than
other
me.
Types of hot ones, and I don't mean wings. But yeah, hot food.
Hot food.
All right, we are moving on here to the
Thank
final
God
round.
We passed without
it's
eating
the final
a wing.
Round. It's the final round.
Let's
it moves
it.
Quick. It's a sprint here on Truth or Dab.
All right.
What I want to do is a collective thought exercise on that side of the set over there, okay? I want you to close your eyes and through this hot sauce-induced fever dream, think about the most insufferable one-star Yelp rant or critic review that you've ever read about yourself. I want you to identify that pull quote, that
easy.
Line that still irks you to this day. Tell us, what is that line? What is that pull quote? And what would you say to that person if you saw them on the street today?
I'm having so much fun thinking about what I would say. You go first. You seem to have, you immediately reacted.
Yeah,
I feel like it was just one of those things. It was super busy, Friday nights in DC, the restaurant. And typically, what I'd like to do if I have 15 minutes in the night, go outside and shake hands, right? Just thank the people, take the folks that just came out over the night. So I did that. I was sitting with one table, speaking, conversing, whatever. And then I just happened to do so with the table behind me. The Yelp review was absolutely insane. Chef Eric came out and greeted every table except for ours, this, that, and the third. And it was just like, the food was bad all of a sudden because of that. Like the whole experience was bad because of that. And it's tough because you can't be in everywhere like all the time. So that for me, I think was like the toughest part. I don't know if that, I don't know.
I have so many. And the hot sauce is really making it hard. I watched people on episodes be like, I don't know. I blacked
there's
out.
There's a fog, a hot sauce
yeah,
fog.
Yeah, you
that
get
happens.
Like a kind of yeah. little head high.
There really
head
is. Rush yeah, 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 exactly.
Someone hand wrote me a letter and had it brought to me in the kitchen while I was cooking. And they had diagrams of the food they had eaten and all the reasons why it was so bad, and then said, you should really think about going to culinary school in the first place. And I was already running the restaurant.
Wow.
And they then took their thoughts and put it on like a 17 paragraph Yelp review,
wow.
which somehow made it to the top of the heap. And you know how you call and you're like, how do we move this?
My sponsor.
Who do I have to pay? Like what? I'll bring my child, you can have her, you can have my apartment, whatever. And they're like, I'm sorry, there's just like nothing we can do. It's like a free world, it's a free country. We felt you should know how people feel about you. And I'm like, wow. Thanks a lot.
To close things out here on Truth or Dab, Season 2 of Alex vs. America, coming to Food Network this summer. Be on the lookout. You don't want to miss it. Alex and Eric, thanks so much for taking on the wings. Let's give them a hand.
Thank you, guys.
Can we fall over now?
Yeah. Hand cut.
I've been trying to act stoic. I'm tasting the other one.
Oh, yeah?
Go for it.
It's going in.
Well, I have to know.
Yeah, you have to know. You have to be it. But did you have to know?
No. Oh, you
I would have started with this.
That's hot.
Really?
Yeah. You know what? You're right. You can eat these and you're dying. Like, you literally see your whole childhood, but you can function.
Way
yeah, yeah.
too soon.
Right, exactly. Like some of those, like,
way
just straight extract sauces or whatever that
hi.
Are just like dorm room
That's
pranks.
That's alive.
Yeah. This was so
this was the
fucking
worst.
Hot.
This was the worst.
Excuse
yeah.
my
this
French.
This was so worse. This is terrible.
Hey, what's going on, Hot Ones fans? This is Sean Evans checking in with a very exciting announcement. We've read the comments, we've seen the emails, and after 6 years, more than 250 episodes, we can now bring you the full Hot Ones experience in one convenient package. I'm proud to introduce you to Hot Ones Boneless Chicken Bites, available exclusively at Walmart and Walmart.com. Each bag of Hot Ones Boneless Chicken Bites is packed with approximately 35 breaded, seasoned white meat chicken bites, as well as individual packets of the classic Los Calientes and the Last Dab Apollo for all your saucing and dabbing needs. The full Hot Ones experience, ready to heat and eat whenever you get the craving to spice things up at home. Hot Ones Boneless Chicken Bites, it's a party in a bag and everyone's invited.